Hey everybody, Sean here from VideoGameManiac.com. Here we are today back in Wonder Boy the Dragon's Trap, grabbing the next stone. We are grabbing the Mouse Stone today. So what you want to do is you want to start up a game. As usual, you can always start a new game, use your own save, or make up your own using a password. I recommend using the password simply because you can cheat and use a password that gives you like all the best gear and stuff. Nonetheless, this is going to be the hardest stone to get, so make sure you are well-equipped. So make sure you boost up your defense a lot, and Hades armor, highly recommended, and have a bunch of thunder power-ups. Once you're ready, switch over to the mouse by either using the altar or by using the transformation sword if you have it. What you want to do is you want to cling to the checkered blocks right here using the mouse's ability, and with the thunder ring, you're able to break those green blocks and then head into the underground. From there, you want to head to the far left, and you want to drop down into that first column, and then it should bounce you back up. You want to land on the right corner of the second column, and then do a small jump and land into the third one. If you fall down the second column, you can always take the door back up. It should send you back to the starting area, and you can just do that until you get that jump down. But once you're here, you want to follow down this cavern right here until you get to the far left of the screen. You'll notice a staircase with two snakes. And what you want to do is you want to go between these two steps, and you can actually drop down here to find the mouse's hidden area. So get through this first part. This hidden area has two screens. This is probably the hardest of the charms to get, simply because the second screen takes some very tricky platforming, and you're also controlling the mouse, who has a very short range and doesn't have the best platforming abilities. And this game isn't exactly known for its jumping. So once you're up here, I recommend taking these two guys out, especially the ghost, because that guy will give you trouble if you leave him alone. And now it's time to start the platforming. So this is going to take a lot of practice. It took me about 3 hours of practice to get all these jumps down correct. So you have a bunch of small jumps right here, then you have these bats. You need to make sure you stop in the right place. You need to turn around and then give yourself enough space to jump and attack them. Alright, next step, you need to jump in midair, and then you want to hold up so you can catch yourself on this row of blocks right here. Jump down, and now you have the trampoline segment. You want to wait till the sun guy is on the far left, and then you want to quickly bounce up, catch yourself here, and then run back. And if you were fast enough, you should be able to kill him. Then you need to jump down and hit that spring, and then go over here. Then you need to make a jump over here. You want to stay on this block, and then just inch away forward and stab this guy right here. You can actually kill him from that angle. Climb to the top, and if you have a thunder power-up, I recommend using it here to take out the second sun guy. You cannot take out the plant, unfortunately, which really sucks, so I'm going to switch my power-ups out, even though none of them are going to be any helpful. You want to drop down slowly, so I just hit right, and that should realign. You want to do a jump. That jump's actually really hard. You need to make it in here and then quickly kill him. That's how you get the key to open up the door. Now you have to make this jump, and try not to bump your head on the second column. You need to make the jump right there. And now what you want to do is you want to run up this column and then jump over to the side, catch yourself, and then just work your way across. Once you're here, you should be good since there's no pit below you. And then you can eventually make your way to the door. Once you're here, just hit up the treasure chest and grab your shard, and you should be on your way to the achievement. So that's going to take, once again, just a lot of practice. But once you get it down, you should get the achievement. 55 gamer score, and that's all there is to it.